I'm going to give a quick update. Knowing that Chris Berlinger will be coming to the board before our next report to give some details about that. So I'm not able to provide a lot of information about our next report, but can give you an update on what we've been doing since our January report. So the key recommendations, the first Catherine's already spoken to, was an interim process to select tenant directors on the TCH board. And then the others had to do with the scattered portfolio. So there was a direction to work together with TCH staff to issue an RFP for the single family homes to the nonprofit sector. And then next were about agency houses. So there was direction to speak to the current operators of agency houses and look to transfer those properties to the agencies that currently use them. Another direction was to issue an RFP, a request for proposals, for an agency to provide supports in TCH rooming houses. So I'll do a quick update on each of these items to let you know what we've been doing. So on the single family homes, we've mostly been working internally, city staff, to determine what the ownership model and the model of transfer would be for these houses before we issue an RFP. We've also brought together a joint group of city and TCH staff to look at those details, so we've been meeting regularly. We've also gone out and done some engagement with tenants of the single family homes, so we held two meetings. One was in, one was at City Hall and one in Scarborough. We had about 80 tenants attend and just gave them information about the upcoming process and got some input into the tenants' sections of the RFP. So how tenants wanted to be engaged with a new housing provider, what kind of, you know, if they wanted representation on the board, what did that look like? And the input we received will form part of the RFP that's issued. On agency houses, again, working internally to figure out the nuts and bolts and details of how that will actually happen. We've been working with TCH closely on figuring out what the terms of those are. We've also reached out to all of the agencies and have heard back about what the preferences are there. In terms of rooming houses, this is a pretty exciting project. We have issued and selected a proponent to provide coordinated supports in the 204 units of TCH rooming houses. And so we've been working closely with TCH. Members of the TCH staff were on the review panel that made the decision. And now we're working on the details of what that kind of agreement will look like between the city, the agency, and TCH. So we're hoping this will roll out. Program should start early in May, and we're really excited about this. What's next? So we are going back to council. I think when we first started, we thought we'd do one report, and it's turned into about 10. And that will further detail the plan to create a seniors housing and services entity at the city, and what the transition looks like to taking on a bigger role with the TCH seniors mandated building. So we need to take a closer look at that. And as well, working with TCH on a specific delivery model for seniors housing. We'll also provide a little bit of update on the work we're doing and what we will continue to do on changes to the TCH's mandate, shareholder direction. That's the work that we have ahead of us, and we'll be coming back to council at the beginning of 2019 when the new council is. So that's us.
Thank you. I'll open it up for a few questions to Jen while she's here. And knowing that Chris is going to be coming also to our next board meeting to answer some more detailed questions too.
Yes, and I do have a two-part question, and I think it might end up being balanced to the board and we can deliberate if they're. Can you tell us sort of how was the reaction? It's always been controversial of the people who have the privilege and fortune to live in those single family homes. How were those meetings in terms of participation and positive, negative?
Yeah, I think there was a mix. I think that, you know, we have a long history of a lot of different ideas and plans for what would happen to the houses and the tenants who live in the houses. So I think it was a lot of our work is to kind of present this path forward and kind of leave the past behind. So, you know, there was lots of relief that the houses weren't going to be sold into the private market. A lot of disappointment from some tenants who had thought that they would be able to purchase their homes. So I think just, you know, presenting that consistent council direction is our job now. So they were challenging some of, you know, some parts of the meeting, but definitely great feedback, and I think that the overall there's support from tenants.
Thank you, and that was exactly what I was trying to draw out, how the tenants themselves who live here, how they responded to it all. I know, and you've heard over the course of time, that many tenants who have lived in some of these single family homes, or whatever we're calling them these days, have put their own sweat equity. Maybe they fixed their own roof, maybe they paved their driveway, maybe they got tired of their landlord, who only budgeted $2,500 per year for capital repairs that just didn't deliver. And tenants have put a lot into them, and I get how heartfelt they feel when they've invested in a real estate property that they thought maybe at the end of would return them, they get a return on their investment, which is not the case. So I understand that they're feeling disappointed. However, I don't know if this is something this, the board, the city, that someone might consider. For the people who have heavily invested financial sweat equity into the improvement of these standalone homes, is there any thoughts around some sort of compensation? If they've sort of, you know, proven fact that they've invested thousands of dollars fixing a roof, fixing a foundation or something like that.
So we can certainly take that feedback back. We don't have direction to do that, but I, you know, I assume in the negotiation post request for proposals that may be something that could be considered.
Yeah, because they get that the house is going to be sold and they're never going to be an owner and it's going to be available in perpetuity for social housing purposes, but they're never going to get out of it when they put into it financially. So that's all I want. I want us to be mindful.
Yeah.
Even if they're market rent tenants, whether they're market rent or RGI, you know, they've invested.
Right?
I've definitely
heard that feedback.
Yeah, I'd just like to see if someone could actually look at that. So we can say, yeah, we heard you.
Yeah.
And we're considered. Okay, thank you.
Any comments on the line? So there's going to be more to follow in terms of this. I think this is timely in terms of some of the points that I'm actually glad that you were sitting in the audience as it is, to hear some of the requests, the word seniors, that we focus on them. And so thank you for coming, and thank you for your patience as the meeting went a little bit longer. But it was great to have you here. And I think we're going to hold on the next item. Is that okay? Because I think that we've had it for information, but I think we should actually report back on it at the next meeting.
I think we just accepted that.